हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, माई सेल्फ डॉक्टर सुनील गाजोरिया फ्रॉम केमिकल इंजीनियरिंग डिपार्टमेंट MIIT मेरठ। इन दिस लेक्चर आई विल डिस्कस अबाउट द वेरियस ट्रीटमेंट प्रोसेस फॉर द ट्रीटमेंट ऑफ द बॉयलर फीड वाटर। एज आई हैव ऑलरेडी डिस्कस अबाउट द वेरियस इम्प्योरिटीज प्रेजेंट इन द बॉयलर फीड वाटर सच एज कैल्शियम, मैग्नीशियम, आयरन, ऑयल एंड डिजॉल्व गैसेस etc. also. Now, the boiler water treatment is a type of industrial water treatment focused on the removal or chemical modification of substances potentially damaging to the boiler. Varying types of treatments are used at different locations to avoid scaling, corrosion or foaming. External treatment of raw water supplies intended for use within a boiler is focused on the removal of impurities before they reach the boiler, and internal treatment within the boiler is focused on limiting the tendency of water to dissolve the boiler and maintaining impurities in forms least likely to cause trouble before they can be removed from the boiler in boiler blowdown. Water treatment is used to improve the quality of water contacting the manufactured product such as semiconductor and or can be part of the products such as beverage, pharmaceutical, etc. There are so many treatment process is shown. First one is the filtration. Filtration is the essential first step before the chemical treatment. It minimizes suspended solid impurities. If rust, sand, silica, etc. are not filtered out, they lead to several scale formations. Second one, coagulation and flocculation. Coagulation flocculation is a process here by adding aluminium sulfate to the raw water. Settlement can be achieved in a considerably shorter time. In additional water treatment, certain chemicals are added to raw water to remove impurities, while some particles will spontaneously settle out from water on standing. This is called a sedimentation. Others will not, to cause particles that are slow to settle or are non-settling to settle out more readily. A soluble chemicals or mixture of chemicals is added to the water. Such a chemical is called a coagulant and the process is called a coagulations. Now the sedimentation. Sedimentation, some particles will spontaneously settle out from standing water, is called as sedimentation. Sedimentation is used to remove the majority of settleable solids from coagulated or flocculated raw water. The solids are removed before the water passes to the filter, hence reducing the solids load on the filter and increasing the efficiency of the treatment plant. Next is the flotation. The natural flotation process differs from the flotation with air. In the first case, material particles lighter than the water, oils or greases eventually associated with the gas bubbles have the tendency to raise the stationary liquid surface. In the flotation process with air, the material particles heavier than the water are transported to the liquid surface by attaching them with air bubbles. It is a process for removing suspended particles from liquid by bringing particles to the surface of the liquid. The influent feed liquid can be the raw water, wastewater or liquid sludge. The flotation system consist of four major components: air supplies, pressurizing and flotation chambers. The chemical precipitation. Now next one is the chemical precipitations. Chemical precipitations is a process in which chemical added reacts with dissolved minerals in water to produce a relatively insoluble reaction products. Precipitation methods are used in reducing dissolved hardness, alkalinity and silica. The most common example is lime soda treatment. Next one is ion exchange. passing water through a simple cation exchange softener, all the calcium and magnesium ions are removed and replaced with sodium ions. The next, the last, deaeration of water. Dissolved oxygen in water is a major cause of boiler system corrosion. It should be removed before the water is put in the boiler. Heating the water with steam in a deaerating heater, part of the steam is vented, carrying with the bulk of the dissolved oxygen. Here I will show you the oxygen scavenger. The corrosion by oxygen in the boiler can be controlled by the addition of sodium sulfide and hydrazine to the pre-boiler section of the steam generating systems. The reaction is N2H4 plus O2 gives the twice molecules of hydro H2O, twice molecules of H2O plus nitrogen. Okay, thank you.